Fantasy football drafts are going fast and furious right now, folks. So we're getting a better look at player values as we close in on the start of the regular season. Hey there, I'm Sports Illustrated senior fantasy analyst Michael Fabiano. And I want to give you guys a look at some players whose stock has fallen over the last few weeks. And we're going to start off in Miami with Myles Gaskin. Now, just a few weeks ago, Gaskin was considered a pretty solid flex starter. Remember last year, he put up a 23% touch share in 10 games for the Dolphins. When he played, he was the featured back. Here's the problem. In the first preseason week, Malcolm Brown started over Gaskin, and Gaskin played with the backups. That is bad news from a fantasy football standpoint. In recent drafts that I've been in, Gaskin has now dropped from being a high-end flex starter to more of a low-end flex starter who could end up being in a backfield committee, not only with Brown, but with Savon Ahmed as well. Now, one game does not make Gaskins a bust, and we'll see what happens in the final preseason games for the Dolphins in that backfield. But for right now, if you're drafting Gaskin, the enthusiasm is not as it was just a few weeks ago. And Brandon Cooks is also seeing his stock decrease. Now, that's a bit obvious because, well, Deshaun Watson is unlikely to be under center for the Texans in week one or maybe at all during the 2021 campaign. So we're looking at Tyrod Taylor or Davis Mills there as the Texans starting quarterback. But Cooks has actually produced 1,000-plus yards in five of his last six seasons, and now he's being drafted as either a low wide receiver three or a high wide receiver four. Folks, I'm going to take the discount there. Brandon Cooks is one of the more underrated wide receivers in fantasy football. Is he elite? Of course not. Not by any stretch of the imagination. But the guy has been reliable, and he's been solid, and the Texans are going to be a bad team, which means what? Targets are going to be there. Game script should be in his favor. So if I can get Cooks as a low three or a high four from a fantasy football perspective, I think that's a pretty good bargain regardless of who's throwing him the football. Hey, folks, for all of the risers and fallers in fantasy drafts, you can check out my columns at si.com/fantasy. And, of course, for all your fantasy football needs, because we are here to help you dominate the competition, make sure you check out si.com/fantasy.